Bumper to bumper was pinstriped, including my cherry spinner hubcaps. I looked around for Von Hutch, but couldn't find him nowhere. Until I gazed at my pad, he was pinstriping the whole house. Like I now possess a completely pinstriped jacket, a completely pinstriped car, a pinstriped house inside and out, which my folks don't know about yet, and the only pinstriped cocker spaniel in existence. Man, like, please, if you know what I should do, please write me. Jerry Madison, 5810 South Normandy, Hollywood, California.
To this tale, after my pop had gone my bail, took the hot rod Lincoln out on a run and getting my kicks and having some fun. It was late in the evening, the moon was pale, I was putting the miles between me and jail. A gal on the cycle was cruising along, I was minding my business and singing a song. Till I saw a sidecar on that Harley and a gal that was stacked like a sack of barley. I didn't know what the gal was a-thinking, but she was poking fun at my hot rod Lincoln. Well, I'm telling you, it didn't set good, because I was proud of the motor under the hood. So I put my foot down on the gas and honked my horn and started to pass. Well, when I did, she pulled away and really took off and wanted to play. Well, I wasn't for racing because the motor was tight. I just got the rods back in last night. Out on the stretch, she cranked it wide open. The rods and the Lincoln kept me a-moping. I was trailing behind to keep her in sight because I didn't have nothing to do that night. No sign of fright, her hair streamed out like the tail of a kite. She went over a hill, the bike started shaking, she was hitting on 90 and really a-raking. Took a curve on the side, a bad mistake, the sidecar cycle went out in the lake. I slammed on the binders and went into a spin, the steering wheel hit me under the chin. I looked for the cycle, the sidecar afloat without any sails that resembled a boat. I looked for the gal and saw nothing but bubbles. When I pulled her out, I had nothing but trouble. I had hold of her hair, she really was sore. She sputtered and gurgled for a minute or more. She finally quit moaning when she got her breath. She said, "You fool, you scared me to death." She cussed me and bit me and wished I was dead and said,
"Don't have to tell him, giddy up, all go. But, oh, Jay, you're making a big mistake. Put on the brakes and take me. You're going too fast. Maybe that's your way, Jay. You never will last. Slow down. Take your big foot off of the gas. Off of the gas. Off of the gas. Off of the gas. Man, I better shake, Jay."
believe? Oh, why can't you be true? Why may believe? Oh, why can't you be true? You don't start about doing the things you used to do. The motor cooled down, he went down. Well, that's where I heard that highway sound. Cadillac sitting like a total late. 110 or half a mile ahead. Cadillac looking like a standing still. Call Maybelline at the top of the hill. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Whoa, Maybelline, why can't you be true? And don't start a back of doing the things you used to do.
And we both came to a screeching halt, at which time I commenced to find out who or what was doing the navigating of this pint-sized bomb. As I approached this vehicle cautiously, the door swung open, and out popped this little 3.5-inch high weirdie, who I found out later was Von Hutch, the Mad Martian pinstriper himself.
Well, I'm telling you, it didn't set good, because I was proud of the motor under the hood. So I put my foot down on the gas and honked my horn and started to pass. Well, when I did, she pulled away and really took off and wanted to play. Well, I wasn't for racing because the motor was tight. I just got the rods back in last night. Out on the stretch, she cranked it wide open. The rods and the Lincoln kept me a-moping. I was trailing behind to keep her in sight because I didn't have nothing to do that night.